Military music at Navy Band Great Lakes has a long, rich history. The first musician, a bugler, arrived in 1908 to the then-new Naval Training Center, and the band was officially established in 1911 when the first recruits arrived for training. During World War I, the illustrious John Philip Sousa led the band as he trained more than 1,500 musicians for the Navy. Today's members carry on that noble tradition in the spirit of their motto, Pride and Service. With a wide range of performing ensembles, this talented group of professional military musicians appear in hundreds of parade, concert, school, public, and recruiting performances throughout its 11th state area each year as the Navy's ambassadors to the Midwest. The Commander, Naval Service Training Command, Rear Admiral Mike Renuck, is proud to present the men and women of Navy Band, Great Lakes.
Thank you.
Served, Navy Band Great Lakes will conclude today's concert with the performance of the Armed Forces Medley. As your service song is played, please stand to recognize your service or your family's service to our country. For today's concert is musician first class Aaron Deakin, and conducting Navy Band Great Lakes is chief musician Audra Ratliff. Another acknowledgement, please, for the outstanding performance this morning. The parade of graduates is underway and will arrive at Midway Ceremonial Hall in just a few moments. Please make sure that all personal items are clear of the aisles and the drill deck. Guests in the balcony are reminded that standing along the rail is prohibited for the remainder of the ceremony. We know that your sailors will have many wonderful and amazing stories for you about the boot camp experience. However, at this time, we offer some video evidence that reveals our side of the story.
Good morning, and welcome to Recruit Training Command and today's graduation. We are very excited to have all the family and friends of our sailors both here and online. You are about to watch the formal transition from recruit to full-fledged sailor in the world's greatest and most powerful Navy. As we honor the accomplishments of America's best and brightest, we must also honor the family and friends of these new sailors. Without you and your steadfast support and devotion, this day would not be possible. Throughout our nation's history, the secret to our military success has always been the military families that stand the watch at home and always support their sailors. The Department of Defense has made the determination that the men and women graduating today have what it takes, and that's thanks to you. So on behalf of the United States Navy, thank you, and welcome to the Navy family. This celebration is not just for our graduates, but for you as well. Take special pride in what your sailor has accomplished and the tremendous journey they are about to embark on. They are our future. Thank you again for your support and all you do to help keep America safe and strong. Enjoy the ceremony, and again, welcome to our Navy family.
approaches some of the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today.
Delaware.
New Jersey.
Georgia. Connecticut. Massachusetts.
Maryland.
Thank you. Division I, 4-0.
Division 1, 4-4.
graduating performing unit is Division 919. Division 919 provides the arrival honor staff, honor guard, the recruit review commander, adjutants, and graduates who provide support assignments for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions. Right. Face. Section leaders, fall out and collect outer garments.
Stand, flat, carry, arms. Forward, assume, formation, march.
Divisions. Counter. March. Divisions, halt. May I have your attention, please? For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand. And we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officer. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill deck. The photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of Recruit Training Command. Division commanders, left or right, face, parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am Lieutenant Jessica Hall, Recruit Training Command's Drill Division Officer. I would like to welcome you to today's passing review. Today, you will see 11 divisions comprised of 759 sailors participate in their graduation ceremony, and soon join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit position at center deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Recruit Andrew Hassenlund from Rochester, New York. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is the Triple Threat Unit on their 6th week of training, State Flags Unit on their 7th week of training, and Staff Unit on their 8th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, all recruits are placed into divisions of 88 personnel and assigned their division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are the key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This is the senior recruit who supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from their right. Division 139. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Amador Tovar Jr. Petty Officer First Class Wilda St. Louis. Petty Officer Second Class Othniel Campbell. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Edward Pedroza from Los Angeles, California. Division 140. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Jovan Barnett. Petty Officer First Class Latoric Portis. Petty Officer First Class Ashley Wallachy. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Liam Bennett, from Virginia Beach, Virginia. Division 141. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer, Brandon Nelson. Petty Officer First Class, Lester Gutierrez-Rivas. Petty Officer First Class, Zachary Rue. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Cameron Pritchett, from Chesapeake, Virginia. Division 142. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer, Dallas Vance. Petty Officer First Class, Jordan McCurley. Petty Officer First Class, Carlos Beltran. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Roel Benitez, from Harlan, Texas. Division 143. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Michael Teagles. Petty Officer First Class, Chelsea Satchel. Petty Officer First Class, Gianluca Capetta. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Chelly Chiconpena. From Jacksonville, Florida. Division 144. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Derek Webb. Petty Officer First Class Adrian Mares. Petty Officer Second Class Tanya Wright. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman John Ibarra, from Orlando, Florida. Division 145. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Kelly McAvoy. Petty Officer First Class Kyle Harrison. Petty Officer First Class Thomas Langley. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Jacques Cody Miles, from Knoxville, Tennessee. Division 146. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Clifford Salvatore. Petty Officer First Class Christopher Slowey. Petty Officer Second Class Norman Milagrosa. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Jonathan Mariner from Miramar, Florida. Division 147. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Francisco Moreno. Petty Officer First Class Unique 10. Petty Officer First Class Chase Frascona. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Jocelyn Allen from Wichita, Kansas. Division 148. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Harrison Moore. Petty Officer First Class Desiree Overton. Petty Officer Second Class Glenn Bell. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Samantha Desmond from Modesto, California. Division 919. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Christopher Ewigman. Petty Officer First Class Sharice Garrison. Petty Officer First Class Deshaun Tidwell. And then Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Joshua Halls from Fresno, California. On behalf of the commanding officer and staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these division commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. In a moment, you will see the ceremonial side boys, boatswain, and honor guard take their places for arrival honors. This time-honored tradition is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for arrival honors, marching under the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered through the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show your sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party? Recruit Training Command, arriving. Naval Service Training Command, arriving. Connecticut 2nd Congressional District, arriving. Guests may be seated.
Thank you.
Will the guests please rise? Present. Arms. Order. Arms. Chaplain Bruno will offer this morning's invocation.
Let us pray. The price of freedom is eternal vigilance. Thomas Jefferson. Hallelujah. God be praised. Our hearts are lifted in joy this morning for our new shipmates, who now stand with us, vigilant and proud. They have experienced crushing setbacks, exhilarating successes, lonely nights, and the camaraderie of individuals we now call brothers and sisters. Bless these young men and women in all their endeavors. Guide them with certainty and a steady hand through the darkest of waters with peace. Eternal Father, may you endow sailors everywhere with the courage to fight with honor and commitment for our way of life, a life of liberty and freedom for all. And may you forever bless the United States of America. Amen.
Thank you.
Our guests may be seated. At this point, the commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Then, the unit commanders would face about and relay the information to their divisions. Today's events show how orders are passed through the chain of command.
Present the graduating divisions. Request permission to commence the review.
Very well. Commence the review.
Aye, aye, sir.
Thank you. Good morning. I'm Captain Aaron Force, Commanding Officer of Recruit Training Command. I think before we go any further, we need to get a little bit more lively. And so, I'm going to give you a cue on the count of three, and we are going to show these awesome new sailors how much we love them. That means screaming, clapping, stomping, let it go. All right, here we go. One, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 759 of the newest and sharpest sailors in the United States Navy.
Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in the following mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of the division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors individually and as teams met performance standards in one or more mission areas. The Honorable Joseph Courtney will now present this week's individual awards, and you will be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Thors, and commander, Naval Service Training Command, Rear Admiral Bernanke. Demonstrated his potential as an effective leader. He has maintained a high standard of personal appearance and an excellent display of military bearing and command voice. Congratulations on your outstanding achievement. Well done, sailor.
Nevada, boarding.
For achieving the highest overall academic score during recruit training, senior Julian Abidar, Division 919 from Waianae, Hawaii, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Lake Defiance Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of the American Revolution. Seaman Abidar receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor! For having displayed extraordinary qualities best expressing the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty, Seaman Jalen Moser, Division 139 from Deer Park, Washington, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Moser is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Airman Jacory McGee Montiero, Division 141 from Atlanta, Georgia, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit and intent of the word shipping. Airman McGee Montiero was given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor! Seaman Robin Yurcha, Division 144 from Temple, Texas, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World War's Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Seaman Yurcha is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor! Association Leadership Award is presented to Seaman Alfred Cabrera, Division 139, from Roland Heights, California, for demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism. Seaman Cabrera is awarded a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Seaman John Ibarra, Division 144 from Orlando, Florida, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places him at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. He is awarded a flag letter of commendation. Seaman Ibarra, the staff of Recruit Training Command salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor! To recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
have the distinct pleasure this morning of introducing our reviewing officer, the Honorable Joe Courtney. Congressman Courtney was elected in 2006 to represent the 2nd Congressional District of Connecticut in the House of Representatives. He serves on the House Armed Services Committee and House Education and Labor Committee. Additionally, he is the chairman of the House Armed Services Subcommittee on Sea Power and Projection Forces. As a senior member of the Armed Services Committee, he has worked to strengthen our nation's defense by leading the call for increased submarine production. Since his swearing in, he has distinguished himself as a tireless advocate for both our nation's veterans and our men and women in uniform. In recognition of his efforts on behalf of veterans, Congressman Courtney has been awarded the Connecticut National Guard's highest honor, the Meritorious Service Award. He has also earned recognition from veterans organizations, including the American Legion and Veterans of Foreign Wars, which named him Legislator of the Year in 2009. Before serving in the House of Representatives, Joe Courtney represented the citizens of Vernon in the Connecticut General Assembly from 1987 to 1984. During his tenure, then State Representative Courtney served as House Chairman for both the Public Health and Human Services Committees. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm Recruit Training Command welcome to the Honorable Joe Courtney.
Well, good morning, everyone. Thank you, Captain, for your kind words, and also to Admiral Mike Bernanke and his wife, Kristen, for the invitation to come visit Great Lakes Naval Station. As chair now of the Sea Power Subcommittee, we spend a lot of time talking about Navy issues, and being here with a graduating class of just such outstanding young Americans is just really inspirational in terms of the work that we have before us at a critical time for the Navy. The Navy's status right now is going through great growth and change. When I first met Admiral Bernanke back in 2007, the fleet size was roughly about 275 ships and submarines. We were in a land war with 200,000 troops over in the Middle East. The Navy provided great service and assistance in that effort. But fast forward to today, the world is changing rapidly, and the mission of the Navy is changing with it. In a short few months, the fleet size of the Navy will grow to 300 ships and submarines. That's been a steady trend over the last about eight years or so. And as many of you know, the latest shipbuilding plan for the Navy is to grow the fleet to 355 ships and submarines. That's obviously a big task, and it requires reactivating our shipyards, again, from coast to coast. But sometimes people forget that you also have to make sure you get the sailors and officers to operate those ships safely and effectively. And that's really the great work that Admiral Bernanke, Captain, and the team are doing here. And the folks, obviously, who deserve our biggest credit in terms of taking on a task for our nation are the graduates here today, along with their families, who provided tremendous support to make sure that they get through this very grueling and tough introduction to the Navy. Again, just having a chance to get a glimpse of the work that you had to do to get through, I am absolutely in awe of your mental toughness and physical agility. And I know you've obviously got more work to do with the mission, with the assignments that you've been given. And again, just talking to a few of you this morning, this is just a great milestone in your life, and you are about to embark on a great journey that will take you and your family to do great things, both personally, but most importantly for our nation, along with your friends and colleagues that you're standing with here today. So again, I just want to tell you, you are part of a great movement that's happening here in this country in terms of our national defense. It is not going to be an easy task before you in terms of what the Navy's mission is. It's more contested and challenged than we've seen in decades. But again, just having an opportunity to see you this morning, to talk to you briefly, I know every single one of you are up to that challenge, and it is a great, great inspiration to all of us. So, real fair winds and following seas. You're going to do great things for our country. Congratulations to you and your family. Thank you very much.
Platoon
Joseph Courtney will now receive the salute of the graduating divisions, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Goles. Please remain seated until your graduates have been placed on liberty.
For our wonderful musicians of Navy Band, Great Lakes.
Flags.
Posts.
Section leaders, fall out and retrieve out guards.
Thank you.
Midway Ceremonial Drill Hall will be closing at the conclusion of today's graduation. Please check the area around you to ensure you have all your possessions. For those families with strollers, please retrieve them as you exit the drill hall. A reminder to those graduating sailors today, you must wear out-of-bounds prior to exiting the drill hall. Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable Navy Days. And without further delay, now hear this, Liberty Call!